Hi, ladies, and welcome back to the Strong Pregnancy series. Today, I have got a deep core and pelvic floor breathwork session for you. Okay, so I'd say that this is the number one session that you should be doing in this series. It is the most important thing to try and master and to practice throughout your entire pregnancy. Okay, it's going to help you keep those deep core muscles, those pelvic floor muscles, nice and strong as baby grows and puts more and more pressure down on the pelvic floor and more pressure out on the abdominal muscles. Okay, so super important session today. You need your large fitness ball, your pregnancy ball. If you don't have one of these yet, first of all, please get one. I use it a lot in this series. It's so useful in your pregnancy. But if you don't have one yet, you can just sit on the floor comfortably for this, or you could sit on a chair wherever you're most comfortable. You also need your long stretchy band, okay? If you don't have a long stretchy band yet, one like this, please get one. If you don't have one, for now, use like a really long towel. Or maybe a long yoga strap if you have one of those instead. Okay, let's get going. We're going to sit on the ball or bring yourself down to the floor or your chair if you don't have the ball. So sitting nice and comfortably. So by nice and comfortably, I mean we are going to try and find that nice neutral posture. So if you saw me on a side, okay, I'm not going to be tucking my pelvis underneath me here, and I'm not going to be sticking my butt out and arching my back. I'm going to try and find that neutral. Sit bones pointing straight down to the floor, spine stacked on top of pelvis and lifting through the crown of your head. Okay, and as we progress through practicing this breath work that we're going to do, and you get tired, you might find you start to slump and that posture starts to go, the pelvis might tuck under. Or if you're more naturally prone to being here, especially if you're more heavily pregnant, you might find this starting to happen. Okay, so really thinking the whole time, sit bones pointing straight down to the floor, spine stacked on top, okay, reducing that impact and those aches and pains in the low back in particular. And then knees can go nice and wide as you need to accommodate bump. You want bump to comfortably be in the middle there, so definitely much wider than hip width, okay? We're going to take your band and we're going to wrap it around your rib cage. So kind of mid rib cage. Make sure you've got an even length on both sides. You're going to cross it over just so you're crossing the band over a couple of inches above your belly button, okay? So kind of mid ribs. You really want to feel it around the back and into the sides of the ribs and holding either side of the band here, okay? We are going to be breathing in through our nose, inhaling through our nose, and exhaling through our mouth. Inhaling through our nose and exhaling through our mouth. Okay, we are going to lift and engage the muscles of the pelvic floor. And we are also going to try and think about engaging and activating the muscles of our deep abdominals. Okay, so we're not overly concerned about these outer abdominals, those rectus abdominals, the ones that kind of come down the front looking a bit like train tracks. They're going to be like the last thing we think about, just kind of closing on our outer shell, the very last thing to close. We want to focus on the feeling of activating those deeper abdominal muscles, those deeper tummy muscles that lay much deeper. They wrap around into our spine. Okay, they really are like those natural muscular corset muscles, I like to think of them as, okay? And to activate those, we want to think of really drawing baby or bump back towards our spine on our exhale. So on our exhale, three things are going to happen. Number one, you are going to close and lift your pelvic floor muscles. So there's different ways to think about doing that. I always think the easiest way to think of it is like a diamond, okay? You've got your diamond laying on your pelvic floor, front, back, and two sides, and the diamond's going to close in and then lift up to your belly button, okay? So all four points, front being the front of your vagina, back being your back passage, and then those two points on the side being kind of either side of your sit bones, okay? So you've got the four points of the diamond drawing in, and then you're lifting that diamond up high inside you. Some people like to think of a flower, kind of with a front, back, and a side petal, and the flower draws in and lifts up. But either way, you don't just want to think like most people do, clench and release, okay? You're not going to get the full network of the muscles that we have on our pelvic floor bed if you do that. You want to think draw in from front passage, back passage, and two side points. Draw in and lift up. Okay, so number one, you're going to draw in and lift up that pelvic floor. Number two, once you've lifted up that diamond, you're going to draw baby or bump back towards your spine okay? And then number three, the last thing to think about is the outer shell wrapping or the corset wrapping. And that's all happening on that one exhale, okay? That's why I say this is probably the hardest, but also the most important thing to practice and master throughout your pregnancy if you can. Practice it as much as you need to. So inhale through your nose and let everything relax. So pelvic floor is just relaxing. You're not bearing down, but it's just relaxing. Bump is expanding, rib cage is expanding into the band. Exhale through your mouth, close, lift that diamond, wrap the band, draw bump back to spine and wrap. All on that exhale. Inhale, release the band pull, release bump, release pelvic floor. Exhale, close, lift pelvic floor, bump back to spine, wrap band. Inhale, let everything release. Expand your rib cage into the band. Find your own pace for this. Don't worry if you're a bit faster or a bit slower. Exhale, close, lift up that diamond, bump back to spine, wrap your core. Inhale, let everything release. We're gonna go to 10. This is four. Exhale, close, lift, draw back, wrap. Inhale, release. This is five. Close, lift, draw, bump back, wrap. Inhale, let everything release. This is six. Exhale, close, lift the pelvic floor, bump back to spine, wrap. Inhale, release. This is seven. Exhale, close, lift pelvic floor, bump back to spine, wrap. Inhale, release. Exhale, close, lift, draw back, wrap. Inhale, release. Last two, exhale, close, lift, draw back, wrap. Inhale, release. Last one, exhale, close, lift, draw back and wrap. Inhale, release. And rest, let everything relax. Whew. There's a lot to take in, I know. There's a lot happening on that one exhale. If it is all too much, this is the first time you've done that, do not panic, okay? You can stop this video as much as you need to, listen to my explanations at the beginning as much as you need to. Play around with different visuals that might help you as well, okay? Until you've mastered it. We're gonna try 10 more reps of that. I'm gonna try and talk a little bit less. I'm just gonna say, close and lift, so that's the pelvic floor, okay? Think of the diamond or the flower, whatever you want to think. Close, lift, draw back, which is drawing bump back to spine, and then wrap, which is that tightening of the band or corset, okay? So close, lift, draw back, wrap. That's all I'm going to say, okay? We're going to take 10 reps. So this is our second set of 10 engagements. Let's go. Inhale, prepare. Exhale, close, lift, draw back, wrap. Inhale, let everything relax. Exhale, close, lift, draw back, wrap. Inhale, let everything release and expand. Exhale, close, lift, draw back, wrap. Inhale, let everything relax and expand. Exhale, close, lift, draw back, wrap. Inhale, let everything relax and expand. Exhale, close, lift, draw back, wrap. Inhale, let everything relax and expand. Exhale, close, lift, draw back, wrap. Inhale, let everything relax and expand. Keep your butt cheeks soft, ladies. Exhale, close, lift, draw back, wrap. Inhale, let everything relax and expand. Exhale, close, lift, draw back, wrap. Last time, inhale, let everything relax and expand. And exhale, close, lift up, draw back, and wrap that core. Inhale to relax. Let the breath return to normal. Good, ladies, well done. That is hard work, okay? That is your deep core breath activation, activating those deep core muscles, those pelvic floor muscles, okay? your number one exercise to practice throughout your pregnancy. Okay, we are now going to add in a little bit more of a challenge for the pelvic floor. We are going to take exactly what you've just done. As you exhale, close, lift that pelvic floor, wrap the core. We are then going to try and hold that pelvic floor up high inside us, okay? So we've closed that flower or closed that diamond and lifted it up towards our belly button. We are then going to try and really actively hold it up there, okay? It's almost like it's gone up to the top of the elevator and you're holding it up at the top of that elevator. Hold it up. And we are going to try and take 10 breaths into our rib cage whilst keeping that pelvic floor lifted up. If you've never practiced this before, you might find it really, really hard. You might not be able to hold up for 10 breaths. You might only be able to hold up for 2 or 3 breaths, then you'll find the pelvic floor giving up and relaxing. That's really normal, don't panic. The more you practice this, the stronger it will get, the more you will be able to hold, the more breaths you'll be able to hold it up. If you can hold the whole 10 breaths with me, please do. You're holding the pelvic floor up, you're gonna breathe into the sides of the ribs. So still using that band, as you hold that pelvic floor up, inhale and just feel the ribs expanding, exhale, feel them releasing, okay? Don't worry about drawing baby in and wrapping the core like we did on the first exercise. We're just really focusing on holding that pelvic floor up, okay? All right, let's go. Inhale to prepare. Exhale, close the diamond or the flower, lift it high up towards your belly button. Now hold it up there, okay? And let's breathe into the ribs. 1. And 2. Keeping that diamond or that flower high up. And 3. And 4. Keep visualizing that pelvic floor, it's lifted high up. And 5. And 6. And 7. Keep it lifted. And 8. Last 2. Last breath. And let that pelvic floor relax. Well done, let your breath return to normal. It's hard work, isn't it, to keep it lifted that whole time. I know it's hard work. That's why it's called practice, okay? It's why I want you to practice it as often as you can, daily if you can, throughout your pregnancy. We're gonna take that one more time, second set of that. You might have noticed your butt cheeks and your hip flexors were starting to grip. That's fairly common in this practice. So on this next round, see if you can keep the butt cheeks nice and soft into your ball, your hip flexors nice and relaxed, take your knees wider if you need to and your legs further away from you if you need to. Okay, so you're learning to engage the muscles of the pelvic floor and lift them up, just the muscles of the pelvic floor. It's like this big bed, this big kind of web of muscles that we're contracting and elevating. You're learning to engage those without engaging surrounding musculature, i.e. the glutes, the hips, okay? Second set of exactly what you've just done. You can go a bit quicker or a bit slower than me if you need to, okay? Make sure you're not going lightheaded. Let's go, inhale to prepare. Exhale, close that diamond or that flower, lift it high up to your belly button. Now keep it up there for 10 breaths and inhale. And 2. And 3. Keep it lifted. 4. And 5. And 6. Keep that diamond lifted. And 7. Soft butt cheeks, soft hips. And 8. Are you nice and tall still? And 9. And 10. And let that diamond, that flower go and relax. Well done. So that is your second exercise to practice in this session, which is your pelvic floor lift and hold, okay? Exercise number 3 to finish this session, we're going to do something called quick fire pelvic floor engagement. You don't need the band now. If you're finding that band useful though, some people like that feeling of the wrapping of the core. It feels very supportive, especially around the front of the abs. You can tie it here and leave it on. If you're liking that feeling of having something physically wrapping you, you're more than welcome to do that. Okay, otherwise pop it to the floor. So now what we're going to do is we're going to breathe in through the nose. So inhale through the nose, exhale through the mouth, like we have been doing, but we're actually going to flip around, swap around the engagement just to confuse you a bit. I'm so sorry. So you're going to sniff in and close and lift your pelvic floor really fast. So just quickly so you understand, you have two different kinds of muscle fibers on your pelvic floor bed. We have fast twitch muscle fibers and slow twitch muscle fibers. So far with that relatively slow controlled breath work, we have been firing up and activating the slow switch fibers of the pelvic floor. So now we want to do some work to activate the fast switch ones. So these are the ones that are going to be helpful if, say, you just sneeze or cough, and quite common, you might feel a little bit of pee come out in pregnancy or early stage postpartum. That's probably because you haven't strengthened those fast switch fibers. So we want those ones to be able to switch on really, really quickly. The sudden movement, sudden sneezing, coughing, sudden jumping, sudden like grabbing something. So that's what we're going to practice. So you're going to inhale through the nose and really quickly, as fast as you can, close and lift. Exhale through the mouth, relax. So it's not slow and controlled like we've just been doing. It's close, lift, relax, close, lift, relax. So your pace might be slightly quicker, slightly slower than mine, but it does want to be a lot quicker, a lot faster, a lot more dynamic than what you've just been practicing. So I'll use my kind of hand to show that visual of close, lift, and then relax. So it would be like this. Okay, so on that inhale, that sniff in, you're closing and lifting the pelvic floor high up, closing and lifting that diamond or that flower. On the blow out through the mouth, you're just as quickly relaxing without that feeling of pushing or bearing down, just relaxing fully, okay? So like that, okay? We're gonna do 10 and then rest and then 10 again. Okay, let's go. Rest. Okay, makes sense? It might have made you go a little bit lightheaded, a little bit dizzy. That's fairly normal if you're not used to practicing this very dynamic breath work with pelvic floor. What I will say is keep practicing. The more you practice, the more you get it into your pelvic floor muscles and into your muscle memory, the less lightheaded it's going to make you. But you will also probably want to play around a bit with your speed, maybe go a little bit slower than what you were just going if it was making you feel lightheaded. Okay, let's go one more set of 10. Okay, so you're going to be practicing two sets of 10 when you practice on your own. Let's go. And relax. Well done, ladies. Okay, so that is your pelvic floor deep core activation breath work practice. I want you to practice that as much as you possibly can throughout your entire pregnancy. It is the number one thing I would say to practice, okay? As baby grows, puts more and more pressure down on those pelvic floor muscles, puts more and more pressure out on those abdominals. We want those deep core muscles to stay as strong as possible. So this is the three separate exercises, okay, that we did. Number one, with the band wrapped around, was the inhaling through the nose, the exhaling, the closing, the lifting, the drawing back, the wrapping, okay, 10 reps. Number two, we then held that up there, held the pelvic floor up once we'd closed and lifted that diamond or flower, and we held that high up inside us for 10 breaths, okay? And then the third exercise was the fast switch muscle fibers, the inhaling to engage and lift, exhaling to release, much faster and more dynamic. I hope that made sense. This is probably one of the most difficult ones to learn and truly understand. It's something that I work with clients with for a long time, sometimes before they fully grasp it. So if you have any questions, as always on any of the sessions, but particularly on this one, I'd say, because it's like the fundamental of everything, feel free to comment on the video or comment on the WhatsApp group or DM me or email me, whatever you want to do. I'm here for you throughout your pregnancy. Okay, well done, ladies. And I look forward to seeing you on the mat again soon.